Philippine Interior Secretary John Vicky Mulya says his agency will run after offshore gaming hubs that are using guerrilla tactics to avoid government scrutiny. Rimulya said this during a hearing of the Commission on Appointments, where he was confirmed as the ILG chief. He urges local government units to inspect establishments before issuing business or occupancy permits. Rimulya cites a karaoke establishment in Cebu Province that was found to be a front for an illegal pogo. Meanwhile, Rimulya says he will personally go to his family's former resort property in December to ensure the closure of pogo operations there. President Marcos earlier ordered a shutdown of all pogos in the country by year end.
Ma'am, the biggest disguise that they are going through now is that they are applying for resorts and restaurants. So it is the power of the mayor to visit the establishments and make sure that what is going on is exactly what is intended. I think the last case in Lapu-Lapu showed it very clear that when the the PAHOC raided the premises, the restaurant and the hotel and the bar were just a front, and then it was a guerrilla operation. If I believe it transferred from the one in Porac, and it hit there.
A sound check on the weather here in the Philippines with Pagasa forecaster Veronica Torres. Veronica.
Hi, good afternoon to you and to all of our audience at ENC. So currently, the northeast monsoon is affecting extreme northern Luzon, while easterlies is affecting the eastern section of the country. For Batanes, we're expecting cloudy skies with rains due to northeast monsoon. For Babuyan Islands, cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorms is expected due to shear line. For Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with chances of localized thunderstorms. Also, we don't have any gale warning raised over any parts of the country, but be careful to those who will travel over extreme northern Luzon or the rest of northern Luzon area, because on the coastal waters there will be moderate rough. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica Torres reporting.
Thanks, Veronica. U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin reveals the existence of an American task force in Palawan amid tensions in the West Philippine Sea. In a post on social media platform X, Austin says he met American troops deployed to U.S. Task Force Ayungin during a visit to the Antonio Bautista Air Base in Puerto Princesa, Palawan. The air base is one of the 9 Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA, sites in the country. The Armed Forces of the Philippines has yet to respond to questions surrounding the role of the U.S. task force. Ayungin Shoal is where the BRP Sierra Madre has been grounded since 1999. China claims the entire South China Sea and has ignored a 2016 arbitral ruling in favor of Manila's claims over the disputed waters. It has since been executing dangerous maneuvers against Philippine vessels conducting legitimate maritime operations in Ayungin Shoal and other parts of the West Philippine Sea. The U.S. also commits more unmanned surveillance vehicles for the Philippines. Washington's defense chief bared this would be included in the $500 million aid for Manila that he announced during a visit in July. The Mantis T-12 is seen as a boost to the Philippines' capabilities in defending its territory. Austin says the U.S.-manufactured vehicle, equipped with sonars and light detectors, was among the priority assets identified by his Filipino counterpart for swift delivery to the Philippines.